Welcome aboard, ladies and gentlemen. Locksmith 2K here, coming at you full speed ahead from Monster Bay in World of Warships. And we are going to start our first of a three video series of the Twilight Battle, which is from the World of Warships 2019 Halloween edition. The purpose of the Twilight Battle is to collect a resource known as Filth. And filth is spent in the armory to get unique camos, flags, XP, stuff of that nature. And along with this, they gave us some unique ships. So we're going to start with the Steel Lancet, which is a destroyer. Now, something to note, the destroyers in this, you do not have control of the deck guns, only the torpedoes. The Steel Lancet has the Repair Party consumable, the Torpedo Rammer consumable, which decreases reload time, and the Engine Boost consumable. Let's take this thing out and see what we can do with it. You do have allies, but you also have two enemy factions that are players, as well as the AI. A lot of times, the other players who are also trying to get the filth resource, denoted by the green drops, we don't necessarily always want to fight each other, just fight the AI. And this is how the AI looks as they spawn in to fight you. And this one would be a destroyer, and it is a ghoul. Was a power up. The angler, which is that guy over there, has the ability to give you power ups. We'll discuss that when I do the second half of this video with the angler. Another one of those power-ups. Now, to collect the filth, you have to be inside this ring, and you can see the number up at the top goes down. It's over the drop. That tells you how much filth is remaining. Now, the in transit up at the top of the screen and the extracted. In transit is how much your team has picked up. In extracted is how much you've actually gotten. You get everything you pick up if you survive. If you do not survive, you only get a percentage of what you've picked up. for a second and collect this filth so that we can get as much as possible. They're working on destroying the fossil. Got it. Somehow I got credit for that. I must have set it on fire or something with secondary guns. So the ships and the way they spawn in, as far as the enemy is concerned, is kind of always the same, which is not necessarily a bad thing, but it does take away from the uniqueness at times. You can kind of plan ahead as to what you're going to do. Notice I don't have the torpedo thing. You get your consumables as you play. So you might get one or two things of this and one of that. It's randomly done. Over here and let our HP recover a little bit. Thank you. his cargo and really shouldn't have done that because he just really hurt his team. Safe exit for all of us. Looks like we picked up 1,419 filth. Also got 25 torpedo hits on target and 235 secondary gun hits on target with one kill. And our raid summary, come to the filth that we got. And then here is the doubloons, experience, etc. that we picked up. Not a bad haul. Now we have transitioned over to the Angler, which is another destroyer. And this is the one that was giving us power-ups. These power-ups are a repair enhancer that recovers HP, a reload enhancer which increases the decreases the reload speed of your weapons, a maneuverability enhancer which makes it where it's easier for you to steer. So every ship has something slightly different. So let's go out with the Angler and see what we can pick up. So this time around we have a Maverick battleship and two Maverick battleships with us, and this is going to play almost identical to the last one, except for whatever choices we make as we go. Down at the bottom you'll see people are already talking about a truce, which is fine. I don't have a problem with that. You can actually turn your guns off, so that you don't shoot each other inadvertently. And sometimes a truce can work to your favor because you can pick up a lot more resources without... dying. Power-ups have a range that the other ships have to be within range for you to actually activate them and then get it as well. Also, the closer you are together, they increase each other at the same time. Oh, and that is a Scarab cruiser. Now, there is a main antagonist in this. It is the Rasputin. That would be him way over there with the 2,000 filth on board. I don't know that my team is going to try to go for that, because we're on the opposite side of the map and we're all pretty banged up. We're going to duck and run because we are pretty much full. We're full. And I don't have the hit points to keep fighting. Ouch. Really? Oh, the portal wasn't open. That was my bad. Oh well. It happens. So that was all we got this time around. Sometimes that's just the way it happens. That other guy really had no reason to shoot me. I wasn't going to do anything to him. But that's his call. So that's going to do it for this episode, ladies and gentlemen. In the following episodes, we're going to do the cruisers and the battleships that are part of this. So stay tuned for those. And until the next videos, this is Locksmith 2K saying fair winds and following seas.